Hey guys, welcome to Tech Academy. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this Rubik's Cube using Blender. So, open Blender and click on File, New, Reload Setup File. First, we'll modify this cube and then we'll copy this cube multiple times and position them at the right position to make a Rubik's Cube. So first, right click on this cube and select it and go to edit mode. Press A to deselect everything. Click on this little button so that you are in the face select mode. And now we'll create 6 different materials for 6 different faces with 6 colors. The colors will be white, red, yellow, blue, green and orange. So expand this window and click on this button, which is for materials. Select cycle sender here and click on use nodes. For the surface, select mix shader. For first shader, select diffuse. And for the second shader, select glossy. Make the FAC value 0.3. And make the roughness value for second shader 0.03. Here, make the color white, here also, and open the settings tab and make the viewport color white so that we can see it here. Name it white. First, we'll create 6 different materials and then we'll assign each material to each face. Click on this little plus button so that we have one more material. Select white. Click on this plus button so that we can get a copy. Name it red. Make this color to red. This one also. And the viewport color also to red. Now click on this plus button to get one more material. Select white. Click on this plus button to get a copy. Name it yellow. Change the color to yellow. Just repeat this step so that we have 6 different colors. Now one more material. Select white. Plus button to make a copy. Name it blue. Make this color blue. Now one more material, select white, make a copy, green, change the colors to green, now one last time, select white, make a copy, orange, and make each color orange. Now that we have all the 6 materials, we can assign each material to each face. So select this face by right clicking on it, select white and click on assign. Now select this face, select red and click on assign. Select this face, select yellow, click on assign. Select this face, select blue and click on assign. Select this face, select green and click on assign. Select this face, select orange and click on assign. Now we have 6 different colors on 6 different faces. Our basic cube is ready. For a Rubik's cube, we need 9 × 3, that is 27 cubes. So we'll just copy this cube 27 times. First, we'll modify it a little bit so that we have a curve. Now go to front mode, front view, and here select ortho. Click on this button so that you are in the ortho mode and front view. Now make sure you are in the edit mode and click Ctrl R and just move your mouse so that you have a vertical pink line and click once. Bring this line here and click again. Now do it one more time. Click Ctrl R. Just move your mouse here so that you have a vertical pink line. Click once, bring it here and click again. Now we need two horizontal lines here and here. So click Ctrl R, click, bring it here, click again. Click Ctrl R, click, bring it here and click again. Now we have two vertical and two horizontal lines here, but we need it here also. So go to top view, click Ctrl R and click, bring it here, click again, click Ctrl R, click, bring it here, click again. When I say click, it means left click. If it is right click, then I'll mention right click. Now you have four lines, that is two horizontal and two vertical on each face. Now we can modify it. So go to object mode and click on smooth. Now you can see that there is a little bit of curve. To make it a little bit more smooth, click on this wrench button, wrench like button for modifiers. Add a modifier like subdivision surface and make the view value 2, or you can make it 1 only. You can leave it 1 and apply. So we have a little rounded corners, edges. Now we can copy this cube. So just go to front view, any view. I'll start with front view and make sure you're in the ortho mode. Select this cube by right clicking on it and make sure you are in the object mode. Press Shift D to copy it and bring it here. Press Shift D again and bring it here. Just zoom in and position them perfectly. Now go to top view and see if they are in the single line. They are. Just rotate it so that you can see that they are in the perfect single line. Select all cubes. So first right click on this cube, hold shift, right click here and right click here so that each cube is selected. Go to front view and press shift D and bring it here. Again, press Shift D and bring it here. Just position them perfectly. Like this. Now select all these 9 cubes. These cubes are already selected. Hold Shift, or you can just press A to deselect everything. Hold Shift and right click on this cube, hold Shift, right click. On each cube. So 9 cubes are selected. Go to top view, shift D and bring it here. Again shift D and bring it here. Just position them perfectly. Now you can see that our cube is ready. Rubik's cube. Each face has a different color like this. Now we need a floor. We can join these first. Actually, we don't need to join this, because if we join this we can't animate it if you want to. So just select each cube, right click on this lamp, delete it by clicking X and delete. Select everything, click on A to select everything and hold shift and right click on this camera so that it is not selected. Again right click so that it is not selected. And now our each cube is selected, go to front view and bring them here above this red line. Now press A to deselect everything. Make sure your cursor is here and click on add mesh plane. Now this will be our floor. Press S and 10 to scale it like this. Now we need a plane behind the camera, which will be our emission plane, which will emit light. So go to front view and here just move the camera here so that it is positioned perfectly. Click here, click on add mesh plane. Now click on S5 and for rotating it press R45, or you can make it 50, enter. Go to material tab and click on new. Here select emission and make the strength to 10. We can change this value later if needed. Now go to view and select camera. This is the camera view. Click on N and select this, lock camera to view. Again click on N to get rid of that and zoom out and just position it the way you want. Now we need to bring this plane behind the camera. Go to front view again and bring this plane behind the camera. Go to camera view again. Now it is positioned perfectly, just like this. Yeah. And go to front view. Go to camera view again. Click on this camera button and you can click on first save it. Select the directory you want to save it in and name it Rubik's Cube. Save Blender file and click on render. It will look grainy now because the number of samples are very less, but it is looking quite good. Now go here, click on sampling and make the render value to 250 so that this is a number of samples, and make this value 0.98 and also the clamp indirect value 0.98 and save it and click on render. It will take some time to render, so I'll get back to you when it is done. Now the background is gray. If you want it to be black, then you need to click on this button and make this value black. I won't do it now. I'll show you the result with black color as the background after rendering this image. Now it is done rendering. To save this image, make sure your cursor is on this image and press F3. Select the directory you want to save it in and name it. And click on save as image. Now I'll show you how to change this value. So click on this button and make this background color black. And again click on render. This is how it will look with the black background. So to save it, again make sure your cursor is on this image, press F3, name it and click on save as image. So this is how you make Rubik's Cube using Blender. And if you want me to do a little tutorial on how to animate this Rubik's Cube, then let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Bye.